Welcome, welcome, welcome to On the Scene with Patricia McDougall, celebrity photographer, and we have a special guest with us today.
Hello.
Mr. Todd Williams, right? Wiggins. That's the
there
name.
You go. You got it right the second time. Plan B.
Oh, yeah, there you go. Hey, and he's the man on the block. He's everywhere like me. He does photos, videos, the whole nine yards, and he's doing wonderful things. And so we just wanted to bring him on tell him the name of your company.
Well, my business is called DC Celeb or DC Celebrity. Mm-hmm. Sounds very similar to what you're doing.
Right.
The website, of course, is dccelebrity.com. And we have a lot in common because we have cross paths. D.C. is a relatively compact city.
Yes, it is.
Which has quite a bit going on at all times.
All the time.
And as you know, not too long ago, we were involved in, I'm sure, inauguration events. I assume you partaked in some.
Yes, I was in the house. I was doing a lot with that. Wore myself out practically. Absolutely. Right from there, we went right to the march. So, you know, the Women's March. It was very, very, I'm going to say, active in the D.C. area. So that was lots and lots of fun. So as we do on the show, we talked about a little bit. And when I come onto the show, I talk about what's going on in D.C. or, you know, what's going on around the city. So, and I know you do a lot, and we'll talk about that briefly. But we want to just talk about right with that. The video I just showed a minute ago, as you could see, that was Albie Shore. He was performing live at Constitution Hall, among other groups that were there as well. So we want to show you some of the footage, not footage, but some of the photos from behind the scenes. And that would be number three from the photos from the 80s party. So if we can show a few of those photos, that would be awesome. Because, I mean, who was in the house? And we were back there just having lots and lots of fun. And the show was live. And then we're going to play that video back again after we show a few of the photos. So let's do that real quick, if we can. And show those are from the, I'm going to say the 80s party. And I'll just name a few of the people who were there. That would have been from the far, it was called Back to the 80s at Dark Constitution. And who was there? Sherelle was there. She sang Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. Chubb Rock was there. High Five was there. Of course, you see Albie Shore was there, of course. And Houdini was there. He's that one with that big hat. Slick Rick, Dougie Fresh was in the house, and he was live off the charts. Oh, my goodness. Now, I'm telling you, in the 80s, it was happening. Now, I don't know. I wasn't here in the 80s in D.C., but I know. Are you from D.C.?
I'm not from D.C., but I have seen several of the performers that you mentioned, and I would have to say that every one of them is a marquee caliber.
Yes, yes. And they all got up there and they did their little rapping and they're partying and they're dancing and they're breakdancing and they're, oh my goodness. I mean, I heard songs I haven't heard in a long time. As you can clearly see, I'm in there with some of the photos. Yeah, that's exactly right. You got them all up in here in the blue. Now, don't let me mix it up now. let me look at my notes here because Denise had them all in there telling who's who. Yeah. This would be awesome there. Look at that. Denise didn't write all the names down there, but I could tell you that's Sherelle. You know, who's who was in the house? That's all I'm going to say. Those are the fives, high fives. So we were just doing, oh, my goodness, that's Chub Rock. And, of course, we know who that is. That's Dougie Live and personal. You know what I'm saying? Slick Rick and who was in the house. And I was in the house, and I was having a wonderful time. And, I mean, I was partying. You hear me? I was partying. We had so many. And that gentleman right here, he's that little that guy there that was in the white, he was actually on stage with Dougie Fresh, and he turned it out. And we don't have any videos here to show you today, but it was live, and it was, oh, my goodness. We were in the house, on the scene, and everything else. But we have a lot of shows that's coming up this weekend. As you know, I mean, not this week. This week is Valentine's Day week. So, you know, everything is going to be going on. And so I do know there's one going to be over there tonight, and I will be in the house. I know you know about that one.
Which
that's
one
Charlie
is?
Wilson, Fantasia, and Johnny Guild. That's going to be at the Verizon Center. So,
oh, really? That's a big concert.
Yes. Yes, so stay tuned.
Johnny Gill, I know that's going to be a lot of women.
Johnny, they're going to be loving him, you know. Yeah, absolutely, it's going to be fun and fantastic. And I just love me some Charlie Wilson, so I'm going to be having some super, super fun with that one. So stay tuned. There's a flyer in there. It's called Eastern Lights Getaways. I'm going to be traveling this weekend for President's Day weekend. And it's just a little flyer. And it's going to be Freddie Jackson, Jeffrey Osborne, Stephanie Mills, and Howard Hewitt. And if you're interested in getting on a bus and going up for the day, contact me. I will be going up on Saturday and coming back on Saturday. And if you're interested in that, you can go up and have some food and have dinner, or you can eat, or you can drink and actually participate in that. And that's if you want to stay the whole weekend. I don't know if they have any buses going that way, but I can get you in touch with who you need to see. And it's just a flyer at the end. If you can, it's called Eastern Lights Getaways, February 18th. And we can just show that flyer very briefly. So if anybody's interested in traveling up this weekend for the President's Day weekend, I know we skip around all over the place because there's so much going on,
yeah,
so much talent. There's so much talent in the D.C. area. Mm-hmm. I know you, and see, as you can see from the flyer, it's going to be fabulous. Now, I've covered them before, all of them at different times in different places, but all in one place? Are you kidding me? Yeah. Isn't that a nice picture of her? She's actually gorgeous, and she puts on a live performance. So you're gonna love her if you're able to get to the show. It's really, really gonna be nice. About 5,000 people will be in the house, so you know it's gonna be Eastern Lights. They really put on a fabulous show. So can we show? We're gonna go take it just back just a little bit, and we're gonna go to photo number one. And photos number one, we're going to kind of move around a little bit.
Okay.
There's a little video in there. If we could just show, if we can, the little video first, and we're going to talk a little bit about that for a quick minute. That was a Dorothy Height stamp. It was the Forever stamp. Did you get to go to that?
No, where was that?
That was at Howard, right across
the
street.
That's a great picture. Did you take that picture?
What? I'm like you.
That's nice.
Wow. We have to show everybody else the photos, too, so they can see it because, you know, we was in the house. Are you kidding me? And everybody knows who Dorothy Height is. I mean, I don't have to say anything. She was a civil rights, and a woman's rights advocate, focusing primarily on improving the circumstances and opportunities of African-American women.
That's right.
So we just love her. And also, John Lewis, he was in the house, and everybody knows who he is, of course. He's always in the...
He's been getting more, even more...
And he was all... We don't even want to say, right? Because we'll start some mess up in here, right? And then the Postmaster General, he was in the house as well. So as you can see from the picture, yeah. And I'm sorry you missed that one. That was a really, really good. And Alexis Herman, she's the president of the Dorothy Height Education Foundation. And also the niece was there, Miss Randolph. And Connie Newman was there. And who's who? I'm going to say Ingrid was there. That's everybody knows Ingrid Saunders Jones. She's the chair of the National Council of Negro Women, and she was there as well. So, I mean, it was just so nice. And you can see, we have a little video showing you when they actually dedicated. It was dedication of the stamp.
Oh,
yeah. So I have a absolutely. And as you can see, it was live up in there at Howard. Howard's always live. You know, it's right across the street from Listen Vision. And, you know, there's so much going on. So, I mean, you know, it's going on in the daytime. I can't go, of course, because I work there full time. Yeah. But, of course, I mean, you know, probably can move around a little bit, right?
I move around, but I don't know. I can't cover the city as much as I'd like. I mean, there is a lot, as you said. Goes on during the weekdays.
Yes.
Starting off at 8:30 in the morning.
Oh, yeah. 8 o'clock sometimes. Straight through. Yeah.
Every day. 5 days, 7 days a week. We got some stuff. If I can mention a
couple
quick things.
You did something. Yeah. And I, you sent me some pictures, Todd. Are you going to talk about the one?
Yeah.
Can you show pictures number 8? We have a picture of Todd up there.
Oh, yeah. This is actually taken this morning.
It was taken this morning,
yeah,
right.
Some,
and talk
there,
a little
some
bit.
There's people
of...
there that are giving out some bags of
okay.
food. Or the toiletries, food, and that sort of thing. One thing I want to mention to people, if you're not familiar with, there is a park. There I am. There's a park.
Yes, number
huge
eight.
Park that goes for 2 blocks
okay.
along K Street between 12th and 14th.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you all know where the park is. The Mark Barnes'
yes,
nightclub,
yes,
et cetera. Yes. Right in front of there is a big okay. facility called, if you will, called Franklin Park.
Oh, we're familiar with Franklin Park. Don't mention that to the Women's March because after that they had some issues over there.
Yeah, I know.
But
I
we
know.
Won't
that
even talk
a,
about
that.
That
was the centerpiece
that.
Of activity
yes.
during inauguration.
Yes.
But Franklin Park is a host
That's
for many.
Eight.
Outdoor uh-huh. street ministries that
mm-hmm.
show up on the weekend.
Okay.
And one of them is called the Essene mm-hmm. Church of Peace, and they serve vegetarian food every week.
Okay.
And, of course, it was drizzly out today, so they decided to congregate under the McPherson metro station.
Okay.
And they had a little gift for everyone who came by.
Wow.
And it was very nice. The food is excellent. And so I just want people to be aware that...
And that's it right have, there.
Yep. Mm-hmm. And that there is organizations out there that are always giving...
Wow.
And a lot of them congregate on Farragut, between Farragut and McPherson
and
Franklin
that's you.
Square. That's me. That's me at another event.
I see. But I like that picture, so I wanted to put it up there.
Oh, okay. Well, that's actually at the opening of the Apple Store, which took place 6 years ago, which was,
oh, wow.
which is on my website, and that was fun.
Okay.
But
okay.
every day, there's always something exciting going on. Just wanted to mention a couple of things that are going on right now.
You can, yeah.
Today,
that's happening where somebody
fact,
can go?
Two things.
Okay. We don't have the pictures to show, but it's
both
okay.
Both of I'll just mention to you right off the top.
Sure, absolutely.
Okay, starting at 2, which is just about now,
mm-hmm.
It's a free event.
Mm-hmm.
It is taking place at the in Bethesda, but so it's right there at the Friendship Heights Metro.
Okay.
The exact address is 4805 Edgemore Lane.
I'm familiar.
Again, that's at Friendship Heights Metro, so you just walk 2 blocks.
Okay.
And it's a culinary talk. It's entitled How Manhattan Changed the Course of American Cocktails.
Oh.
So that is at the Bethesda Chevy Chase Regional Services Center, which again is available by Metro, only 2 blocks from the Friendship Heights Metro Station. Those kinds of events goes on mm-hmm. every couple of weeks, and those are free events, and sometimes there's tastings that go with it or receptions.
Okay.
So that's one of the tidbits that I'd like to share with people because these kinds of things are happening almost every day.
Mm-hmm.
Also, this if you happen to be downtown, between 6 and 8,
mm-hmm.
tonight we have at the 5th Street Ace Hardware, 1055 5th Street Northwest.
Okay, I'm
we
familiar.
Have,
we don't have pictures to show, but you know.
Well, you
yes,
get there,
we'll
it'll be plenty
yes.
to see, I can assure you. 6th Annual Ladies Night.
Okay.
That's for Ace Hardware. And that's going to be fun. I've been to those before. There's usually music. There's maybe some snacks. But it is an opportunity to get discounts on hardware or anything, household goods that you might want. Ace Hardware is obviously well known. They have many locations throughout the D.C. area. So if you want to have fun, meet some other ladies, eat some other people, that would be a good way to do it and get some discounts on things that you probably were going to get anyways for your house. So that's again, it's tonight at 1055 5th Street Northwest, Ace Hardware, not far from downtown Metro, Verizon Center, et cetera.
Okay. So as you can see, there's a lot going on. And thank you so much for sharing them.
Sure enough.
So, you know, if you want to, you can also follow him on Facebook as well.
Yeah, Meet Me DC.
How about that? Well, moving right along, I don't know. Did you watch the game? I guess you did.
Which game
are
was
you,
that?
I know.
Which game are you referring
the
to?
The football game.
Oh, that
the one
game.
That was 32-28.
Now,
How about that?
Was
number three. Wasn't that interesting?
That was very interesting.
Now, you know, I'm not going to say I don't even watch sports, but I mean, you know, I watched that one, and I'm not kidding you. We want to congratulate the New England, right? They
New
won
England
it,
Patriots
right?
Definitely pulled they, it out.
That's, yes,
that was
they
a miracle,
do.
Some people would say. But
that, oh, my goodness. My girl Denise, she was upset. She's from Atlanta now. She was like all gung-ho for that one. And,
yeah.
And when they came back at the last minute. I have a few pictures up there, as you can clearly
you really?
See. Yes.
Oh, yeah. That's.
You know, I wasn't there, but it looks like I was there.
That was,
you know?
97. 97. I don't know his name, but he was on the defense, and he made it partially possible by some great defensive performance.
Really?
Yeah, a few sacks, I believe.
Okay. Well, that was Tom Brady in the picture.
Now, Tom Brady. No,
that's
97.
That his number?
And then there was Tom, see that
yes,
guy right there?
Yes.
He made it possible, partially
for
possible,
them to
for
win?
Tom Brady to win. Yes.
Oh, you got.
Great
he's the one that
play.
Slid over the end, touched the ball on the line, and all that stuff.
He's a defensive player. That's all I can tell you. But I do know that it was a team effort.
It was a team effort, and they did a fabulous job, and they won, and I was really happy. But, you know, I had to say and call them out because they did a good game.
It was a great game, especially if you're an advertiser, because you want a game to be suspenseful to the very end.
That, like, if you took, what do they call it when they start, you know, betting these monies on them?
Oh, it's all right.
Whoever.
The bookies are happy with that one, too, I assume.
I was saying to myself, I wish I had that one for, because that was really good. Because if you said they're going to win in the last inning, I guess, or
whatever. But someone knew that.
They got some big
dollars.
There
were people out there that were expecting this, believe it
really?
Or not. Because when the game was 28-3 at the halftime.
28-3.
That was Atlanta was leading.
Wow.
And pretty much looked like it was going to be a blowout, right, at that
it
point.
Did.
And we went into the half, and we saw those gaudy commercials that we saw, and then when we came out of the half.
Right.
Apparently, they must have had a talk in the halftime proceedings, and basically things just flipped, flipped.
Yes, it did. So, but we just want to say congratulations to the team that won, and congratulations from the team that tried really hard and almost won.
Congratulations to the advertisers who really benefited from that.
Yes,
as well.
And also to the ones who got paid at the end of the day, right? I wish it was
sure
me,
enough.
But of course I didn't get paid.
Next time.
But next time, I guess, right?
All right.
But anyway, we're going to go to a little number four, the photos with Leah. She's with Edison High School. That's my daughter. I had to throw out there because she plays basketball and they won the game. This was her last game of the season. And everybody was saying, you know, it was my birthday on February 6th. So I actually went to a game. They're like, what are you doing at your birthday at a game? I go, I have to go to a game. She wouldn't let me live it down. So if we can just show a few pictures. And they won the game, and they played a good game. So I want to give a shout-out to Edison High School. She's Leah's number 24.
Okay.
To Edison High School basketball, girls basketball. Yep, that's her. And she helped to, I'm not going to say she did all the shots. She just helped the team
what
effort.
What is her position? She played forward?
She's number
or
four.
She played forward.
I don't know. Leah, what is your position here? She's center?
She's a center. So she's the one that gets most of the rebounds probably too, right?
That's right. That's right. She's the center.
And she shoots.
And she can shoot. That's right. And this is just her first time playing. So
really?
Considering her first time playing on a team, I think she did pretty good. So I want to give a shout out to Leah for doing such a good job in, you know, playing on the team. How about that?
And to Mom for enjoying it and seeing it.
Yes, that's right. Because I love basketball more than football, even though I do watch a little bit of both. But it's all good. It's all good. So we're going to talk a little bit about the car show.
Oh,
now,
yes.
I know you went to the car show.
Oh, absolutely.
Okay. All right. So they had a couple of events. That's photos number three.
Mm-hmm.
And so what was your favorite car over there? So we're going to show a few of the pictures there. Like, I don't know. I was just in all of them. Now, I was admiring the BMW. I mean, no.
That's
the Mercedes.
But that's an interesting. I didn't see that one.
Oh, are you kidding me? Now, we're going to show some pictures
What's
shortly.
What's unusual about that?
That's my car. That's my next car. I don't know. I just like it. It's a, I guess it's an SUV or truck or whatever. Okay. I don't know. It's,
you know, got an interesting grill in the front, so that's sort of protected in the headlights and so on, I guess.
Right? Yes, well, you can get that on any car.
True.
But, you know, but that protects your lights if
so
somebody backs up.
So how much would
that
cost you?
That car? That car right there is $100,000.
Really?
Easy, yes.
You sure?
It might be more, but it's not less.
Wow.
Yeah, because I was interested in purchasing that car. So I said, you know, that's going to be
you
my
got name. It like that. Congratulations. That's all I could say. I'll definitely chauffeur you around if you ever need any help.
And I ran into a few friends.
Oh, that's a Bentley
there,
back there.
And that's a, yeah, that was the floor. That was the regular floor over there. We was in the VIP.
Oh, yeah,
was,
that's nice.
You know, having a little reception upstairs.
Oh, yeah, that means free food, right?
That means free food, free drinks, yes.
Yeah, we like free food.
And, you a know, little
you
bit
know,
of,
my phrase is free food tastes better.
Oh, my goodness, yeah. Yes, it did. And the food was really good. But then when you got to the car section, you know, I had to get in one, as you can clearly
that's
see.
That's a classic Stingray right there.
That right
and that
there.
That looks like a Bentley. I really like that one. That was a beautiful car with the tan interior.
Yes,
and
yes.
And, of course, in the sunroof and the whole, wow, what a nice package that was.
Isn't that nice? And I don't know how much a Bentley is. Probably 200, right? What do you think?
I don't know.
It's up there in the digits, yeah. And, you know, that car right there, the actual outside of the car is matted.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, and that's matted, and the Bentley was matted, as you can see.
Oh, yeah, the matted, you're talking about the paint style.
The paint on the outside of it, yeah. So I hope you were able to get the car shows over now in this area.
Oh,
I'm
yeah.
sure they're going to move over to New York and different places, so you'll be able to go and see, you know, the car show in other places.
Now, Cadillac had a great reception at the Longview Gallery, and I would like people to be familiar with Longview.
Yes.
Because they have quite a few art openings, but mm-hmm. sometimes they have either private shows. In this case, they had a preview to the car show with
okay.
the Cadillac reception.
Wow.
And that was the Wednesday, so that would have been, I believe, the 24th. The show, I believe, started on the 26th.
And the address for that is, where is it, over here on 9th?
Longview Gallery is opposite. It's on the west mm-hmm. side of the convention center.
Yes, I'm familiar.
Right sort of across the street.
Yes.
And so they have hosted some great art events, but Cadillac was there this year.
Did they have a car in there?
They had a few.
Oh, yeah. My. Oh, yeah. My. Yes, I went in there one time. I walked in there. I said, wow, this is really nice.
It is.
Have a show in here. One day, that's the place. Mm-hmm. If you want to go and have an event, or either that's it, they have it open now. It's wide open where anybody can go.
Longview
is only private.
Open. It's open for private events.
Okay.
And it looks like it used to be some kind. I think it may have been a mechanical mm-hmm. shop or something.
Right.
Because it's perfect for moving cars in and out.
Yes, it is.
They've got a garage
is.
Door in the back.
Yes, I saw.
They've got
right.
a nice alleyway exit. So
yes.
you got something big you want to bring in, then they can accommodate you on that. And they've got can really decorate the place and make it in whatever theme that you want. I'm sure they can accommodate you.
Absolutely. And so, speaking of the arts, mm-hmm. We're going to show photos number 4. A friend of mine's held an art show down at I'm trying to think the name of
Pepco
the
Edison Pepco. Gallery.
How did you know? Did you go over there?
Yeah, I had something to do with that.
Oh, you're familiar with this show? Oh, you can tell us.
I was
so
there.
You were there, of course. Uh-huh. You know, you got to be kidding me. I'm forgetting. So fair. Tell us a little bit about this show. Did you remember the name of it? Because it's still going on. And I don't remember the name of it because I don't have the information, but it is still going on. And you
okay,
might want to go.
Well, it's for Children's National Medical.
Children's Hospital?
Yeah, that's right.
Yes.
And you're familiar with that. They're up on Irving Street.
Yes.
And they had a show of young artists who displayed all types of their three-dimensional work. They mm-hmm. had paintings. They had photographs. They had all types of styles. You can see that there's one of the pieces right there, which was
right.
impressive. It looked like a mural almost.
Oh, it's absolutely gorgeous.
And,
yes.
and the talent that was displayed there, I thought, was amazing
mm-hmm.
in terms of the variety.
Mm-hmm.
But also we had some spokespersons. We had kids that could get up and explain to us what they were thinking, what
mm-hmm.
their concept and their theme was, how they executed, what materials they used.
Oh, they were awesome.
Wow. That was really a great experience. And there's, I believe that's a woman that sort of curated it all.
Yes, she did.
And
yes, she did.
We'll
she actually called me and asked me to come out. She actually asked me at 4 o'clock. I said, you got to be kidding me.
Oh, you made it.
But I made my way down there. I promised I'd come. She just got her PhD, and I congratulate her. And so there's a few photos up there of a couple of people that was there having a wonderful time. I don't know everybody's name, so I don't want to give a shout-out to anybody. I'm going to give a shout-out to everybody.
Okay.
How about that? Do you know any names? Anybody in there? I'm not familiar.
Well, I will say this. The Pepco Edison Gallery.
Yes.
Which, of course, is, I believe it's co-sponsored by Pepco.
Yes, it is.
Which is essentially right across the street. That's on, the gallery is on 8th Street, and then I believe Pepco's on 7th Street or 9th Street, and it's nearby. Mm-hmm. And so they've had many different great exhibitions there.
Yes, they have.
And that's another place if you want to have an event, especially if you have a nonprofit organization that you feel might be relevant to their interests.
Because you have to be a nonprofit to actually use the facility. Right. You have to be some in art related, correct? Yes, but right now it's booked up into all of 2017.
Oh, is that what they
did? Yes, they did. Oh. So I guess you'll have to follow me in 2018 because I'm going to put my bid in there, find somebody that's nonprofit. And bring my artwork there. Maybe we can, you know, try to do something together. Okay. Because between, I mean, all the artists that's in the D.C. area, there's so much going on.
It's, sure
you
is.
Know, and we go in and we capture that. Mm-hmm. And we just bring these photos to life.
Well, you are a videographer as well as a photographer.
Yes, so yes.
That's one another way of capturing because we want to get the audio in certain cases that we can.
Yes.
But the point is that if you're there, you want to show what's going on, right? You want people to feel it.
I want them to feel it. That's why I do the photos and the videos, and I do a little bit of videos. Like, there was a young lady who sang, and she was really, I loved her music. I don't know if we could play that, because I do have a little clip of her. I don't know her name, but we're going to play that video if we can.
Okay.
And show her singing. And she actually sings with a group. I don't know her name.
Solo guitarist.
Yes, yes. Are we able to play that video right and show her in her elements of her beautiful voice?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's take that.
It's a city bonfire, sit in the circle. Everyone I get higher, look in the mirror, just to see if you're dying. Hell, are you crying?
I can see it. Oh, no. That's why I always get a little bit of music here and there and everywhere. But we want to, I want to go back to how you say the show that we did, because I know I have another video in there and play that in a little bit longer because I wanted you to hear some of the 80s party. I think there's another video in there, if I'm correct. I'd like to be able to play that other video if we can.
Okay.
Yeah, that was kind of cool.
And what show was this again?
This was the 80s party that you missed,
oh,
the Dark Constitution.
No, oh,
it was called Back to the 80s, and we were partying in there. Are you kidding me? There was two videos, right? There's two videos in there. There's only one. I thought there was two, but it's okay. I want you to hear some of the rapping towards the end, the one that's in red.
Oh, you're talking about with Dougie Fresh again.
Yeah. Okay. Well, it was another one. I'm not sure if it was Dougie Fresh, but there's another one.
Washington, D.C. We brought
over there. As you can clearly see, we're having a little audio issue, but it's all good. It's
so what
all
was it
good.
Like to be there? Was it, did you feel like you were back in 1983 or 4?
In the 80s, yes, I did. Yes, I did. They brought it home. They were bringing the audience to life. They made them stand up. They engaged. They came out into the audience. They worked the room.
Ah.
It was the whole nine yards. Yes.
Oh, that sounds great. So Dougie Fresh, when I hear him, I've heard him recently.
Right.
Gosh, man, he is so gifted.
Right.
I mean, his ability to rhyme and to spontaneously excite people
is
good as you can get, possibly. I'd love to see him in the Grammys again. I'd love to see him in something like a major, major stage.
Because right.
I think he's done a lot of local things. He's probably circulated around.
He deserves
exposure.
Oh, he is. And he's in a lot of places. I've been to many big places. He's there. Mm-hmm. Now, he gets the party going.
Mm-hmm.
Like, truly, like, you don't, I mean, seriously, like, if you want to have a party, you need to invite him on stage. That's it. Then the party takes off and it is a party.
That's it.
That's it. Dougie's in the house, right?
And he's still fresh after all these years.
And it's so funny. You see him backstage. He's so calm, so cool. You know what I'm saying? And then he comes out there and he just gets it going. He rouses the whole audience. Mm. But the gentleman I was talking about was Daddy Kane. Right? I said
Big Daddy Kane.
I wanted to show some of his video because he was actually rapping in there, but I'm not sure if we're able to do that. But he is rapping in one of them, and I wanted you to hear some of the words.
Okay.
So
well, we can
it's
try
not
that
possible.
Next time we get a chance. So
get
it queued up and everything like
that. We can actually show that. Okay.
Big
so,
Daddy Kane.
Yeah, because he's actually rapping in the video. But
okay.
We want to take it because I know this is February and this is, how would you say,
Black History Month.
So we want to go to photos number 2 and talk. And I'm sure, and I'm going to show you because I'm sure you can identify some of the artists in there too, just to give a shout out to.
Recognizability.
Some of. This was actually at the African Museum, as you could say, and we're going to show some of the pictures. And I was actually behind the scene, as you can see. And then we're going to give a shout out to the new African Museum because it's African History Month, and because this right here, you need to visit. You need to go there and see your history.
And by the way, I'm going to give you a quick little quiz.
Yes.
Do you happen to know?
And then we just want to talk a little bit about this, and we're going to come back to that.
Sure.
So these are different photos from back in the, I guess, few years back or recent or whatever. And this was the March on Washington. And as you can see, I was there celebrating the Dr. Luton legacy. That's right. And you can see
Marion Barry
was in the house, and everybody, my Denise was in the house, and everybody. And so the reason why I put these pictures up, because everybody in the photo is not me, of course. I'm just a photographer. But, it's all good. But you know,
I want to
give a shout out to everybody. Now, like I said, you asking me questions about the artists in the picture. I don't know all the names. And I said I'm not messing it up, and I'll tell you them later.
Okay. I recognize John.
Look, he's gonna stop. You know, he's gonna start asking me names, and I don't have my engineer over here that gives me the insight on all the names. So I don't want to say any names. But who's who is in the house of the photos, and we want to give a shout out, and as I know you know who they are, look, including me, because I was at the march, right? And so that's when they first opened up, and of course we got the president. We want to give all the love to him because he was the first African-American president. And showing all the love. And this is at when we went into the new museum for the first time. And as you can clearly see who's in the picture here, right? Mm-hmm. Yes. And so I just wanted to show a few pictures and give a shout out to all and say that we are here and we are celebrating Black History Month
mm-hmm.
for February. So on the next show, I'll show additional photos and just kind of put it up there for you to see and show some love to all of who are actually part of history. So tell us a little bit. I know you were starting to say something about
when you went to the building. What did you think of the new
The new museum?
Mm-hmm.
It was what I expected. I thought it was very nice. It's well structured. The different rooms, the different floors, the different levels. I mean, I've been in there. Matter of fact, I was in there with my sister. She just came out of the hospital. She's feeling much better, and I took her over there. And she was in love with it. So I enjoyed it.
Okay. So
tell us a little bit about it.
Did you feel that you understood where you were going, that you, I don't know what your priorities were when you went in, but...
Well, when I went in, remember, I went in when it was a party. So I went in when it was a lot of people, and it was a lot of artists. So it was ironic that you should ask me that question. But when I went in, I mean, I saw it, I saw the floor, mm-hmm. but I was more interested in capturing the photos of the people who actually participate in the opening. Mm-hmm. So I was engaged in looking, you know, down, and I didn't really take a tour that day. I actually came in and took photos of who was there. So some of the pictures I showed you earlier.
Okay. Well,
but then when I started walking around the first time, I didn't even I felt the energy in there. However, I went in like the third time, the fourth time, the fifth time, and I still, the other day that I went in there just 2 days ago, and there was a floor that I didn't even know exists.
Which ones?
I think it was on the fourth floor. And it was like when you go on the fourth floor, there's a circle, and then it has all the videos that play around. And then you have the car, then you have the spaceship, the mothership. But before you go into the mothership, there's two rooms on the left and the right. Mm-hmm. They're art rooms. Did you know there was art rooms mm-hmm. in there?
I didn't.
You didn't even know there's art rooms because it looks like it's just a wall and it's round. But if you go in the rooms, there's another room full of art.
Oh, that's great.
You see? You didn't even
that's
know
that.
That's
what an art gallery should do. It should reveal itself in layers.
And they're actually getting ready to have a revolving floor that actually, whatever's in there now, they're going to take it out, remove it, and they're going to bring some other things in. Mm-hmm. But the other floors, I heard this too, the other floors that you see, then that stuff is there. It's not going to move. They're not changing it or anything. That's going to be a part of the museum, and it's going to be set. But the other floor I told you about, I'm not sure what floor it is, but they're actually going to, it's going to call the revolving floor. Oh. And they're going to change it out every so often. I don't know how often. It's but virtual. They'll bring in some new things because everybody, I mean, there's so much to show.
Yeah, there is a lot to show.
So what was your favorite floor?
Well, I'll tell you, the first floor is the first.
Well, the first floor, you don't see anything. The first floor is where the food is.
I have to admit to you.
The first floor is where the VIP.
One of the reasons I really like the floor is because I actually met the architect, and his name is David Adige. He's from Ghana.
Okay. The architect of the building?
The architect of the entire project is David.
Okay.
Adige.
Oh, I did meet him. Yes, I did. Uh-huh.
He's a brilliant and somewhat understated person. When you meet him, he's very subtle.
Okay.
He's not as braggadocious as someone of his stature might be, but I'm just impressed with his persona, which I think really exposes itself in the subtlety and the sort of elegant nature of the designs that he's mm-hmm. executed, especially in this particular case.
Oh, it's beautiful.
The building itself is essentially, it's a big square. It's a
yes.
big box.
Yes,
but
it is.
But it has these, you know, angular fluorescent feel about it in layers that is unique. It's very different from anything else that's on the mall, obviously.
It sure is. It sure is. But they're talking about building a women's museum out there. Can you picture that one? I don't know where it's going to be, but we're going to see.
I don't know where it's going to be.
I don't know where it's going to be, but I'm going to see.
Is there any room for any more museums right
any more museums in there? But anyway, the structure of this is really, really nice. And like I said, did you go to the opening? Were you there for the opening?
I was not at the opening, so I have to rely upon you. And
did you get to go in to see all the floors?
I saw most of the, I didn't see the part that you said, the fourth floor.
You wouldn't even know it was there. It was a mystery. And then they have where you saw the sports mm-hmm. floor.
Yeah, that was great.
Right? And then you went all the way down. You was at Oprah. You went to the Oprah. Has a theater,
mm-hmm. That's
right?
Mm-hmm.
You can go into the theater, hear lots of different things. So there's so much to be seen in there. So if you want to know about history, African history, you need to go there so you can read up. And then spend the whole day. Go early and stay late. And there's a restaurant. Did you go to the restaurant?
Yeah, I've been there.
Several times? Oh, my goodness. Now, like I said before, bring your money because you will be spending. But it's well worth spending the whole day, taking time, take a break, and then just go back at it again and go from the bottom to the top of the floor and all. And there's even a waterfalls in there. I didn't even know there was a waterfall. Did you see the waterfall?
It's a nice
there?
Touch.
When it goes down, the water's in there, and just sit it. I don't know what they call that room. There's a certain name to it, but I saw that. That was the last time I went in there, and I was like, I didn't even know this exists. But then, and I said, you know what? And I'm by myself when I go in there, so I can really get a feel for it. So you need to go out there and just check it out.
Okay. Well, there's diagrams also online if people want to get a feel for it, even mm-hmm. if they have not been there, or maybe you're out of town.
Right.
And you want to know what to expect when you go to see it. Lots of pictures. And again, shout out to David Adige and his crew for their successful accomplishment in completing this project.
Yes, because he did a fabulous job. And then tell us, I'm going to go back to that picture you showed earlier mm-hmm. about the love, the bag. Is that still mm-hmm. going on now?
Well, no, that was this morning. But
okay.
I will say this. This particular group, Mm-hmm. It comes out every Sunday at 11, and they offer a brunch to anyone who's fortunate enough to be there.
Okay.
Now, it is a vegetarian brunch, so if you're big into meat, then that's not going to be your place. But there are other places that you can go to and other churches that will certainly offer you what, you know, what you may be looking for.
Okay.
But what I like about those folks is that the food is very healthy. It's an interesting buffet. It's a wide variety of white and brown rice.
Okay.
They've got stewed vegetables. They've got a lentil stew, which is which is beans, essentially. They've got fresh bread. Bread's excellent. And they've also got mint tea. So you can have mint tea
with,
that's naturally sugar-sweetened with brown sugar. And they're out there, like I said, just about every Sunday, rain or shine, at Franklin Park. And
I'm
since
familiar.
It was raining today, they gathered under the McPherson
Was it raining?
Metro. It was raining.
Oh,
it is still
it's warm
a little
now.
Drizzly out
oh,
there right
yes,
now.
Yes. A little, but a little warming up. I mean, this weather's crazy, too. Did you get any snow? You didn't see any snow. Did you see? You saw a little snow? And New York really got hit hard. Like my brother says, you don't know we have all the snow. I got to go outside and shovel. I'm like, hey, send some this way. I could use a little, but not too much. No, not too much.
You got some fur coats and everything.
So, you know, we don't have to go to work, remember?
Oh, that's the reason. Oh, well, in that case, I can understand.
We have a little couple of hours in between here and there.
There you go.
Yeah, so you know, I hope you're tuning in. I'm gonna have some more pictures on my website at www.patriciamcdougallphotos.com. You'll be able to follow me and find some more photos. So please, I hope you're checking it out and going back to my page. Did you get a chance to look on my website
sure
yet to see my photos?
Of course I did.
And see some of the events you've been to, and some you have not, and some you know what's coming up next year, because some of them, you know, every year it's the same thing. You know, DC is like, you know, it's a cycle. Everybody comes back. Everything comes, you know. And
that's where it should be.
That should be, right?
Regardless of the administration.
Exactly. And so what we do, and I know what you do as well, is like we come out and we highlight all these major events, and then we come to the show and we tell everybody what's going on or what's going to go on. Because they would say, Pat, I didn't even know about that. Like I was at this show and this girl said, damn, Pat, you didn't even say, that's the word she used. I didn't use it. She said, you didn't even tell me they're having an 80s party. I said, well, you didn't even call me. How am I going to know? So anyway, so when I put the picture on Facebook or the video... She was like, what's going on here? She was like, what about me? Like me, if I see something, I put it on live so you can see it's going on.
Get, there you go.
You better come on down to Constitution because it's live up in here. They ain't even playing. So I was trying to show some of the rap, but I don't know. It's not working. Will we come back to the rapping part yet? Is it going to work for us? Because I know we're getting ready to chime out of that.
If it doesn't, you just put it this way. You missed it. But it was good, right?
You'll have to follow me on my YouTube page because I'll post it back again. And then they'll be able to see the video entirety and see that we was partying. When I say we were partying, we were partying. So tell us, I know you mentioned three other events that you'll be going to, but anything else going forward that you're familiar
with?
Well,
this is obviously a big week for a lot of people because of the commercialized Valentine's Day that's going to be celebrated by some in 2 days, on Tuesday. It'll be the 14th.
Yes.
And so many of you have associated events with that. The catering companies should be busy with that. Delivering
flowers
and chocolates. So if you're a chocolatier and you're not busy... then something's wrong with your plan, because this is the time of year that chocolate is a big deal.
That's right. That's right.
Flowers are obviously another big deal. Music should be a big deal because some people want to be serenaded. Right?
Serenaded, right. And if you need me to come out and take a picture of you to serenade or whatever, you call me. Or if you need to give a frame with a beautiful picture that says something nice on it, call me too.
There's a good
can't
reason.
Call me, call him.
There you go.
Look, I can't be everywhere. That's I'm just going to keep it real. You know? So I share a little bit of my, you know, my work that I do in all the different areas. I tell everybody, you know, there's something going on. They need to come out there and participate. But the one that's coming up, like I said, that's going to be on Saturday, the 18th, is going to be with Eastern Lights Getaways. And it's a bus. It's a tour bus that's going there. That's Freddie Jackson, Jeffrey Osborne, Stephanie Mills, and Howard Hewitt. So I want to thank you for coming on, listening on the show. And I want to thank you for coming on the show and joining us today.
I've got one little tidbit for you.
Yes, okay? Very briefly.
For someone who's downtown, Raheem Devon is going to be playing at, you remember the old Love nightclub?
Yes.
1356 Oakie Street?
Yes.
And Carolyn Malachi at Ivy City Smokehouse, which is over in Ivy City, as you well know.
Okay.
And then there's also something called Not another boring Valentine's Day, which is going to be at the Jack Rose Dining Salon or Saloon,
okay,
which is 2007 18th Street. So that's right on the base of Adams Morgan. So if you feel like going over and enjoying that, then that's convenient to Adams
Morgan. See, so lots going on in D.C. So we're going to chime out and thank you and follow me on PatriciaMcDougallPhotos.com and listen and also tune in every Sunday, 2 o'clock at Listen Vision. We are live here. And you could always find my friend Todd.
Todd on dccelebrity.com.
He's a celebrity. So, hey, Patricia McDougall, celebrity photographer and DC celeb. Thank you for chiming in today.
Bye-bye.
Absolutely.
To sit out.